Buenos Aires, Argentina. Thousands of miles from home. Unless you live in Argentina. Tonight, 20 Britons who've already failed on the Total Wipeout course have come back to fail again. But one will redeem themselves and become Total Wipeout champion. Not again. And their names shall echo through the annals of time forever. Just like that guy from the last series. You know, what's his name? Hello, the hat. Anyway, this is Total Wipeout, the Legends. Hello and welcome to the Total Wipeout Legends Special. What do I mean by legends? Well, essentially what's happened is that all the worst but funniest competitors from the last three series have been invited back to have another go. Let's face it, they all fell off things last time. Odds are they'll do it again. So that's what I mean by legends. Let's see what the legendary legends will be up against today. The Qualifier, a thing of legend. Crash Mountain, another thing of legend. Dizzy Dummies, truly legendary. The Wipeout Zone, really, truly legendary because this one's got a ledge and an end. Now, I'd like to hand over to someone who's always there to encourage the competitors. Someone who brightens up the show. Someone who's got a big, caring heart and a gorgeous smile. Unfortunately, though, Eduardo's camera shy. So instead, let's go over to Amanda Byram, who's with today's first competitor. Ah, yes, it's 45-year-old Dynamo Joe from Yorkshire. Just what's needed, a really strong, confident competitor up first.
Who's the daddy? Who's the daddy?
This guy was one of the bounciest competitors ever seen on Total Wipeout, but was surprisingly knocked out by the sweeper last time around.
It's been over a year since I've seen you last. What did your family think of your performance?
Oh, they loved it. Even my daughter's school friends call her Dynamo Hannah now, so it's... You know, it's dropping down from family to stay at that again.
Take your time, Joe. Take your time.
What are you here to prove today?
I'm here doing it for all the little, short, ugly blokes that are balding, getting 47-year-old. Oh no, I've done it again, wrong again.
Just breathe, Joe. Breathe.
Joe. Thank you very much.
High five.
I hope he pulls himself together before he starts.
You've seen the least from the east, and you've seen the rest from the west. Now the dwarf from the north is going to show you him best.
What?
Yeah, I think Joe is officially nervous. But that's okay, we'll excuse him that. And he's on. Sorry, let me do that again. He's off. Yes. Right, the first obstacle for Dynamo Joe is the dodgeball. Oh yeah, four legends in their own right. And back again to welcome the competitors to the qualifier by pelting them with small red balls. Apparently they can only speak four words. Duck, dive, dodge, and destroy. Yeah, so after those early nerves, this looks like a decent start for Joe. He's doing well. He's not doing so well. Yeah, takes his first hit but tries to lie down when he probably should have run for it or something. The sucker punch. Joe failed to cross the sucker punch last time. How will he do now, having had that practice? This is looking good. Oh, yes, clear. Yeah, the big balls now. Okay. Dynamo Joe, here he goes. Yes, yes, oh!
All that practicing, that jumping.
Joe, don't interrupt her. Don't ever interrupt Amanda. See, it was good bounce, and then another good bounce, and then, no, it all went wrong. Now, the only thing between Joe and the finish line are the cradles of doom now. Let me just explain how these work, using a detailed description and some state-of-the-art computer graphics. You jump across them like that. Right, Joe's put his early nerves behind him. Can he finish in style? Yes, he can, in a time of 1 minute 44.
Who's the daddy? Who's the daddy?
Clearly Joe's the daddy.
Yeah, Dynamo Hannah's daddy. We all know that.
I was listening to you saying something about not Dynamo Joe Muhammad Ali. What was that?
Oh, it's my little rhyme. I was saying to this other bunch, float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. I'm Dynamo Joe, not Muhammad Ali.
Oh yeah, wordsmith as well.
What a great way to start the Legends special. But now we need someone who can really light up this course. Not literally, though. Obviously, there's a lot of foam out there. I mean, it's all undergone extensive fire safety testing and everything. It failed. They can catch fire really easily. I mean, even friction can do it. But I'm sure it'll be fine.
Now, who's this? I can't quite tell.
I don't believe it. It's the one and only Maria, a true legend of legends. She wowed the nation with her dancing and with her uncrushable spirit last time out. She epitomised what Total Wipeout is all about, getting coated in mud and falling over a lot.
Amazing!
So Maria, have you been doing much of the physical stuff in order to prepare you for this today?
Well, it's funny you say that. I've been for one run. I've done a few sit-ups and a moonwalk. I've got that down to a T, so that will help me get through.
Oh, yes. I can't wait to see this moonwalk. Any minute now, she'll do the moonwalk. Seriously, any minute, she's gonna moonwalk for us. It's going to happen.
Oh, I nearly fell over there.
Oh, dear.
Last time, I was the one and only, but this time I'm back for the final countdown. Because I'm simply the best.
That was a medley! Beautiful! I've missed you, Maria! A new challenge awaits, of course.
Oh, no.
Yeah, dodgeball. Good dodging. Oh! Right on the noggin! Ow! That's some pretty accurate ball throwing. But Maria doesn't move an inch. She's a professional. Yeah, oh! Yeah, that's to be expected.
Oh, yeah, she certainly is the one and the only.
Now Maria will be hell-bent on making it through the qualifier after finishing one place from the bottom last time round. The magic on the ball should go a long way to making that happen. Come on! Oh, Maria, watch out for the motivator! Yeah, that's the motivator.
That was a big boom!
Yeah, it was!
I can still see the imprint of her bomb.
Maria, you have been motivated! See? She got a move on, didn't she? It does work. Look, 1 minute not going, next minute going. Really fast with her eyes shut. Fabulous. 75 quid that motivator cost. Money well spent. So it's on to the cradles of doom. Oh, good. Ooh, she's made the first cradle. Come on, Maria. A strong finish here. Come on, the whole nation is behind you. We are. I want you to do well. Come on. Here we go. Here she goes. Oh, no.
Whoops.
The one and only Maria finishes in 5 minutes 24. Just one thing left for her to do.
I am the one and only. Nobody I'd rather be.
That's my girl. Yeah.
That was unbelievable.
I tell you what, boom, boom, literally boom.
Right, who's next? Oh, brilliant, it's 38-year-old Sunbed Johnny.
Welcome back. Orange as ever, I see.
Yeah, still using the sunbed, hoping to win so I can get another one.
Listen, a lot's happened since the last time I saw you. Tell me what's been going on.
Well, my twin brother came, didn't he? And he won. So, I mean, I can't go back empty-handed this time. There's a lot of rivalry between us. I've just got to beat him, need to beat him.
Now, Sunbed Johnny's dodgeball experience from his first time on the show should stand him in good stead. If you call getting your head knocked off by a ball experience. So he's doing better than last time, but he's still sort of on his feet. Oh, no, spoke too soon.
Spot the weaker brother.
If he wins, Johnny has said he's going to buy another sunbed. Oh, yep, yeah, that's just what that guy needs, isn't it? Another sunbed. Yep, here we go. Oh! That's not mud splashing out of the water, by the way. That's fake tan. Yep, your brother is going to love that. Johnny's time of 2 minutes 46 is pretty good, but will it be enough to see him through to the next round? I don't believe it. It's 37-year-old MC Philly Phil. He hails from the mean streets of Barnsley. He may not look like an MC, but check out his flow.
I'm Phil, I'm 33, I'm in the place to be. I want to win this thing on the BBC. I got my mama in the hood, saying I should try my best to beat the rest.
MC Philly Phil is back, no doubt, with something extraordinary lined up.
Obstacles come in different shapes and sizes, but the best ones are always the surprises. And I know I'll be in with a shout when I find out who's gonna wipe out.
Yep, yeah, that was extraordinary. Phil went out on the sweeper last time, so in the words of popular rap artist Mr. Snoop Doggy Dogg, will he make it to the Wipeout Zone this time round? Easel.
Well, not if the dodgeball boys have any say in it. No! Ooh. Ow! Ouch! Oh, guessing that kind of hurt.
What are you here to prove today, Phil?
I'm here to prove that anybody off the street can just become a rapper, become a dancer, become a Wipeout celebrity.
Yeah, well, one out of three ain't bad, Phil. Yeah. Time for MC Philly Phil to freestyle with the sucker punch. Here we go. Oh, ah! Yeah, Phil proves he knows how to get down and dirty. Very dirty. That's a time of 3 minutes 26 in the end, quicker than Maria, slower than everyone else.
And that, my friends, is a wrap.
That's four legendurous performances down. And while I'm making up words, next to run are a pair of competitor Ets from the sunny south coast. Who will be crowned betterest? Will I start speaking normally again? I really hope so. I'm annoying myself.
Ah, remember Charlene, 21-year-old makeup artist and former Miss Bournemouth. She was a real girly girl. Yeah, she looks so pretty in pink. Less pretty after a visit to the qualifier. Well, she's back now to prove she's the queen of the English Riviera. While Bournemouth has Charlene, Portsmouth has Amy, the 19-year-old model immortalised by a pair of magic shorts. She's back to prove she's the South Coast finest.
Amy, the last time you were here, you had what we tend to call in the business quite a few of those wedgie things, didn't you?
Yeah. I don't care if I get a wedgie. I'm not pulling that out. I'm going.
So Amy is up and away. Oh dear, did she just already? Yep, the magic's returned. Hard to believe they are different shorts. I'm hopeful Amy will have a strong start because she is desperate to make it. Oh no, I'm way too hopeful. The dodgeball boys, of course, are suckers for a pretty face, so I expect them to go easy on Charlene. Yep, they're definitely going easy on her. Oh! I really must stop saying things like that! Yeah, this is a disaster waiting to happen. I'm not talking about that hit on the bombs. Those red balls, like, totally clash with that pink leotard thing. It's terrible. Back to Amy and her new magic shorts.
She wouldn't pull them out of her bottom.
Yeah, well, we can all make promises like that, but come on, needs must. Right, the sucker punch. And, oh, Amy's already in. That mud is almost 30% motor oil, so it should help those squeaky shorts at least. No. Can Charlene do any better?
She's so pretty in pink.
No. Charlene got all the way to Dizzy Dummies last time. She'll want to make the most of this second chance and go one better today. The big balls now. Oh. Oh yeah, sheer delight etched on her face. Good to be back, eh, Charlene? Quite superb form off that second ball. Amy and her new magic shorts finish in 3 minutes 19. But Charlene does it in 3 minutes 13. And formerly Miss Bournemouth takes the title.
Only one wedgie this time.
Was there only one? I can't remember.
Bye.
So Charlene is Total Wipeout South Coast Queen, but can either of them make it into the next round? Today's first Legends leaderboard looks like this. Dynamo Joe's up there in top spot with Sunbed Johnny in second and formerly Miss Bournemouth in third. Amy and her new magic shorts are in fourth, with MC Philly Phil in fifth and the one and only Maria in sixth and last place. This just gets better. It's 42-year-old Irish athlete G-Force Geraldine.
I'm a living legend for life!
Yeah, which might not be very long depending upon how the qualifier goes. 42-year-old Geraldine exploded through the qualifier, but surprisingly crashed out on Crash Mountain back in the hazy mists of time. Well, she's made it to the balls in super quick time. This woman only knows one way. Now she knows two ways. Yeah, and that one's the wrong way. Geraldine bringing a bit of Irish tradition to the Total Wipeout qualifier. Someone really must have a word with the wardrobe department. We're all sorts of trouble this week. This is looking like a very good time. And she's on to the second cradle. No, she's overbalanced. Or is it underbalanced? She's fallen off is what she's done. And either way, that is the most surprising fall of the day. She may be strong, Those shorts are very small. She must feel the breeze. That is a quick time of 2 minutes 23, which puts her in second place for now. From one explosive competitor to another, it's the quite fantastic Exploding Kenny. He was the guy who... Well, yeah, exploded. That's what he does all day as a science communicator at the Glasgow Science Centre. Apparently.
These legends don't frighten me! I'm going to be the most legendary legend!
Yeah, Kenny, you're supposed to go out with a bang, not kind of start with one, because we'll come back. Moving on, these next two competitors have one thing in common. Besides them both being men and both being called Ali, it's that they both left Total Wipeout cursing their size and weight. 39-year-old Ali had a unique approach to the big balls.
I tried to do like jiggity biggity, diggity bop. But I done like jiggity biggity splash. That is fun, isn't it?
Ali, how you doing?
Hello, honey. Nice to see you back. Yes, I am here again.
And have you been down the gym pumping extra iron so that you can ensure first place this time?
No, the first time I was a little bit chunky and heavy. This time is I cut the protein.
So Ali reckons he's lost weight. Okay, let's have a look. It's like a very difficult game to spot the difference. Even the vest is the same. I hope he's washed it, that's all. 26-year-old Disco Al showed off his dancing skills way back in Series 2. Back then he claimed he was going to eat the course. No, really, he did.
Since you've been here last, what kind of stuff have you been up to?
Well, I've been away and I've got back from this, realised I am grossly overweight and very unfit, so I've went to the gym and I've lost 3.5 stone since then. So
good for you, so you're extra fit this time.
Yeah, it may not be like super fit, but you know, it's better than I was, so fingers crossed I'm here to smash my qualifying time from last time.
Just lay off the dancing, Al, and you'll be fine. Might have lost the weight, but he hasn't lost that dancing talent. You can't lose what you don't have. That's a new move there. Yeah. Paul the Lawnmower, a perennial favourite. Always a good
one. You, and you, bring it on!
Yeah, the only language they understand, Alistair, is pain. Yours. Dodgeball is first for Disco Owl. Yeah, successfully batting them away so far. Nice, neat.
Oh!
On his face! Up you get, Owl. Come on.
Oh. Get off your back, Alistair!
No mercy. Oh, dear. Okay, so not a blistering start, but there is a long way to go. Can Jiggity Justice Biggity Ali do any better? He's doing well so far. That enormous amount of weight he's shifted apparently seems to have made all the difference. Yeah, do check you've had a spray in my eye. It's hot out there. Oh, getting pretty hot out there on the dodgeball as well. Oh, that's gotta hurt! Right on the tip of the nose! Back to the disco diva now as he approaches the big balls with all the enthusiasm of a man who's already experienced just how much they can hurt. Come on, Al. Come on. Never mind, the motivator is poised and ready to spring. That was brilliantly bad. Disco Al slips on the ledge with quite spectacular consequences. He really is an all-out entertainer. He's doing it for us. Can Ali match that? What's he got lined up?
How do you feel about the big red balls?
Jiggity, piggity, boom. No, jiggity, piggity, diggity, boom.
Yeah, of course. Why would he do anything else? Quick glance at the ever-stationary motivator.
Jiggity, piggity.
Splash. Jiggity Justice Biggity Ali makes it home in 2 minutes 26, which is a good time. Now, can Disco Al finish with a bang? One cradle of doom. Here he goes. Oh! Ooh. When I said bang, that wasn't what I had in mind. Disco Al posted a time of 4 minutes 5 seconds, a full 8 seconds faster than last time. Well done, Al! No strength left to cheer, but he's happy. Right, Eduardo's found all the bits of Exploding Kenny and stuck him back together and defused him. Here he is at the sucker punch. Ah, that looked painful! Okay, all sorted. Who's next?
Marion.
Who? Oh, CSI Marion. Yeah, I remember. Ish.
What's the main reason for you being thrown into the water the last time, Marion? Well, initially, it was those dodgeball boys.
Yeah, she took quite a pasting back then. And she was blonde. That'll fox her.
But this time, I'm not getting in the water at all. I'm staying dry.
Bold words. 43-year-old police diver Marion made it into the top 10 first time around. She was 10. But she's going well, and she's the first person today to make it past the dodgeballs. Cradles now for CSI Marion. One down, one to go. Making the transfer tricky, she does it, two down. So still sort of one to go, that final leap. Can she complete this as well? Yes, she's done it! The first to complete the cradles today with a very quick time, 2 minutes 13. She is today's fastest lady legend. Back to Kenny now, who's making good time on the qualifier. He's already at the cradles. A good finish here should see him just about... Why do I always do that? Sorry. Like a damp squib, exploding Kenny's squelches over the finish line in 2 minutes 54 seconds, which means he's safely in the top 12 for now. He really wants to get that looked at, you know.
So that's 10 runners run, with several still unrun. And already, as I had hoped, the Legends show is delivering. They fell off things last time, and they're doing it again. Lots. I love these guys. Anyway, it's time for another legendary legend. I can hardly contain myself. Don't worry, I have. It's just this belt's a bit broken, isn't it? But I am contained. Who's next?
Oh, yes, it's 19-year-old former pastry roller from Cornwall, Perrin. He's got the most spectacular sweeper wipeout to his name, along with the least spectacular interview technique.
Perrin, you are just oozing cool. Are you excited about the course today?
Yeah.
Really looking forward to it then, are we?
Yeah, man.
Can he contain his excitement, having been asked back for another bite of the Total Wipeout cherry?
So, is it good to be back on Total Wipeout, Perrin?
Fantastic.
Yeah. Yeah, he can contain his excitement, he can. Right, he's off. And it's dodgeball first, remember. Now, these boys are part human, part robot, whereas Perrin's part Cornishman, part Wookiee. This could be quite a battle. Ooh. Moving when you see it in slow motion in a really odd sort of way. This is a very quick time as Perrin speeds towards the big balls. Whoa! Oh! Oh! That was tremendous! That's gotta be the fall of the day on the big balls. Incredible! Perrin onto the cradles in a flash. Makes his move, second cradle now. Can he finish in style and leapfrog Joe at the top of the leaderboard? Yes, he can, in an electric 1 minute 34. Now, he must have something to say about that. Mm-hmm. Come on, a comment. Yes. Mm-hmm. Give the man a chat show. The Legends leaderboard now looks like this, with Chatty Perrin in top spot, Dynamo Joe in second, and CSI Marion in third. G-Force Geraldine is fourth, and Sunbed Johnny is sixth. Exploding Kenny is seventh, formerly Miss Bournemouth, eighth. Disco Al is down there in 11th with the one and only Maria in 12th.
They might not have realised it yet, but the epithet legend wasn't necessarily bestowed upon this lot because of their brilliance. Although in Perrin's case, he is good, isn't he? Chatty, no. But good, yes.
These next two legendary ladies are a right pair of speed queens. 25-year-old Bouncy Becky was the fastest girl in her show, and 30-year-old Can-Can Claire was the quickest in her qualifier. But who can go quickest today? And can either of them outpace Perrin? I bet they can't. I don't know. Now, on Becky's previous outing on the qualifier, she became one of the very few to manage the dodge part of dodgeball. How will she get on today? Ouch! Ow! Ow! Oh! Yeah, that makes her success first time around start to look like beginner's luck. Back in her previous show, Can-Can Claire screamed around the qualifier on her way to a lightning-quick time that saw her top the leaderboard. But dodgeball is a whole different kettle of bearded Argentinian ball-throwing fish.
Her bottom's eating her shorts!
Yeah, that is happening. And like Amy, Claire ignores her unfortunate wedgie and powers on. Meanwhile, Bouncy Becky has reached the big bouncy balls in a very fast time.
Bounce, bounce.
Yes?
Hang on, oh!
No, it was all going so well. Claire and her carnivorous shorts are onto the cradles now. The university lecturer and part-time burlesque dancer needs a strong finish here. There she goes. Yes, yes, oh, no. Still, despite her very obvious impairment, Claire reaches the finish line in a rather tasty 2 minutes and 8 seconds. Recruitment officer Becky is looking even faster as she takes on the cradles. Quickly onto the second. Ooh, and rather too quickly off it. Still, a time of 2 minutes and 6 seconds puts her up towards the top of the leaderboard. Who's next to go? Ah, yeah, it's the 23-year-old puppeteer from Surrey, Catherine.
My name is Catherine V. Rock, and the V stands for invincible.
No, it doesn't. V, there's an I. V stands for invincible, which isn't really a word. In case you've forgotten, Catherine was the one who brought that freaky puppet with her.
In a pie.
Don't be fooled by Catherine's sweet demeanour, though. She is one tough cookie. Not that tough, obviously. It's like being at one of the kids' parties she takes that puppet of hers to. Right, Catherine the ventriloquist moves on to the cradles. Ooh, makes them move. She's across! That's a surprisingly good time of 2 minutes 28. Before moving on, I'd just like to take a moment to highlight a common interest amongst lots of Total Wipeout contestants. Amanda. Several contestants a week confess their undying love for my co-host, even when she's laughing at them wallowing about in the Argentinian mud. And these next two are no exception. This sexy thing is Dean the Builder from Darlington. And this Casanova is Danger Island Tom from Gloucester. Last time round, Dean had his eye on just one thing, and it wasn't the 10 grand prize.
Amanda, I'm doing this for you!
Dean fell for Amanda, all right. In fact, he fell for her several times. Although I got the sense Amanda wasn't that impressed. But Dean's got some competition.
Danger Tom is back. This is for you, Amanda.
Tom's infectious enthusiasm and general geekiness had a strange effect on Amanda.
Please, sucker punch, don't get my little Tom.
And Dean's apparently written a song for Amanda that comes from the heart.
My name is Dean, and I can't sing. You won't hear me wind your moan as long as I'm in the Total Wipeout Zone.
Dean, are you sure? Now, can Dean impress Amanda with his performance on the big balls?
What strategies have you got that you're going to do differently than last time?
It's going to be all brain instead of brawn this time. Using that, and that's what I didn't use last time. That's it, it's all brawn, totally brawn. With obviously a bit more brain.
It's like listening to Stephen Fry. Dean cunningly waits where the motivator can't get him. This guy's cleverer than he looks.
No. No, he can't.
Love a man, oh, where can
I have to say, in his defense, in slow motion, that is strangely elegant. While Dean's been impressing Amanda, Tom has made it to the sucker punch.
Oh, sucker punch, please leave my Tom alone.
Oh!
Oh, no! No!
Yes. That's just rubbing salt in the wound for Amanda. It's Dean's turn to shine now. Steps casually onto the first cradle, then the second. Good grief! Well, what woman doesn't like a man who can walk quite quickly across foam cradles? And in 2 minutes 22 seconds! Yes, and Amanda's got to be even more impressed by that. It's 2 minutes 7 for Tom. Now, who's this?
Dr. Monkey's back and I'm going to swing through this course!
Dr. Monkey? Why was she called Dr. Monkey? Oh, yeah, she's a doctor. Yeah.
Remind us what that was all about.
I think the best way to describe this, Amanda, is in action.
Okay. Nurse, can we get the sleeping gas again, please? And the screens. Dr. Monkey made it all the way to Dizzy Dummies last time, so she'll be determined to go one better today.
Oh!
You can't punch a doctor. It's not allowed. Well, the way this is going, though, Heloise is in for a cracking time as she approaches the big balls. And that is quite a jump. Oh, quite a fall. One always follows the other.
More like a spider monkey.
Now I'm the king of the swingers, oh, the jungle.
It's an interesting technique. It's more like a frog than a monkey, I think, technically. Yeah, swinging next. This is much more Eloise's thing. She does actually seem more comfortable with this obstacle. And this is looking like a good time. Oh, well, it is 1 minute 33. That is the fastest time today. After that incredible run, Dr. Monkey is today's most legendary legend, with Chatty Perrin in second and Dynamo Joe in third. Bouncy Becky is fourth, Danger Island Tom fifth, and Can Can Claire is sixth. Dean the Builder is in eighth, Jiggity Just As Biggity Alley is tenth, with Sunbed Johnny scraping into the top 12 in last place.
Well done to those legendary 12 who are all one step closer to their first visit to the Wipeout Zone. But you can't have winners without losers. That's what I call total wipeout karma. For every good thing that happens, an equally funny thing must also happen. So it's time to remember the losers. For them, this is deja vu. They've tackled total wipeout again. And they've lost. Again!
Christopher Columbus sailed the seven seas. Sir Ranulph Fiennes conquered Everest. And I once swam 25 meters in my pajamas at Solihull Swimming Baths. But all of these legendary feats pale in comparison to this next challenge. Only five will stand victorious. Seven will ultimately fail. It's time for Crash Mountain. On podiums one and two, it's Sunbed Johnny.
Ali, you may have the muscles, but you haven't got the suntan. You're going down, boy.
Fighting talk, I love it. And Catherine the Ventriloquist.
My name is Catherine V. Rock, and the V stands for vengeance. I'm gonna beat you, Crash Mountain.
She's been practicing that, she can spell now. On podiums 3, 4, and 5, it's Dean the Builder.
Man versus machine. Dean the Legend will be victorious. Whoa!
Pure poetry. Dynamo Joe. Looking like a tiny stormtrooper. And CSI Marion. On podium 6, 7, and 8, it's Chatty Perrin. Keep it down, Perrin, please. G-Force Geraldine. And Jiggity Just As Biggity Alley.
Hey, Johnny, the muscles coming from Brussels. When you fall down, I will laugh loud. Ha, 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 ha.
Johnny looks scared. On podiums 9 and 10. It's Danger Island Tom.
Where am I? I don't know where am I looking. There.
Yeah, this way, Tom. That's it. Okay. There you go. And Can Can Claire. And finally, on podiums 11 and 12, it's Dr. Monkey and Bouncy Becky.
I was Queen of the Crusher, now I'm going to be Queen of Crash Mountain.
Legend tells of a game where 12 heroes become 5. That is the legend of Crash Mountain. Are you all ready?
Yeah! Yeah!
Oh, I don't know why I bother asking. 3, 2, 1.
So the legend of Crash Mountain begins.
Coming.
For the majority of these competitors, those from the first two series, Crash Mountain is an entirely new challenge. So this could get messy. Oh, and it's Can Can Claire, a Crash Mountain veteran, that makes the first move. She needs to time her run. Oh, she's down. Oh, and so is Perrin. Claire proving that experience counts for nothing. Perrin just completely missing the bridge. Bouncy, Becky and Dr. Monkey both launch themselves and miss, as does Sunbed Johnny. Nervous Joe is on and swiftly off. Jiggity Jetta's Biggity Alleys overshot the bridge. Still no one on the middle or even close. They're coming thick and fast now. I can't keep on top of this, nor can they, it seems. There's Perrin. Oh, my word, Perrin. Up to his old tricks again. He's already got the Best Sweeper Wipeout Award, obviously after the Crash Mountain one as well. That was brilliant. Quality work from Perrin. There's Marion. She just missed out on the Dizzy Dummies last time. She won't want to miss out again. Determined. No, she's down. There's Geraldine. Oh, and Jiggity Jester's Biggity Alley. This lot seem to have forgotten the golden rule of this game, avoid the sweeper arm. Seems Perrin's just diving in the water for fun now. Another one for the Total Wipeout archives. Good on you, Perrin. Still no one has made it to the middle. Right, that's Dean the Builder.
Come on, Tom!
The impartial Amanda Byron there. Dean will not be amused. What can Danger Island Tom do here? I'm hoping he'll stand up and skip his way to the middle and... Oh, way too hopeful.
Okay, I'm going to make bets that Tom doesn't make it across this anytime soon.
Impartial and so supportive. Police diver Marion is on again. Quick, no! Marion goes for a dip, a real busman's holiday for the police diver. Dean now, he's been surprisingly quiet, but he's made it! Well done, Dean, first of the day.
Dean the Builder, can he run it? Yes, he can!
Only four places left up for grabs. Who can join Dean the Builder in the next round? That's Dynamo Joe making a dash. Can he hang on now? Yes, he can with a helping hand from Dean. That display of chivalry has got to impress Amanda. This is really hotting up. It's the last chance saloon for the remaining 10, with only three places left in the next round.
He's got in the way again.
This is so tense, I can hardly watch. Dr. Monkey's turn. She is today's fastest qualifier. She makes a dash and, oh, she's done it!
Yes!
Only two places left now. Perrin, he's off. At least he's landed on the bridge this time. And he's made it! Today's fastest three qualifiers have all made it through to Dizzy Dummies.
One more!
So, still fighting for that last place in the next round are Bouncy Becky, CSI Mary, Danger Island Tom, G-Force Geraldine, Sunbed Johnny, Ventriloquist Catherine, Can-Can Claire and Jiggity just as Biggity Alley. Catherine doesn't fancy leaving the show just yet. But Marion's just taken her out. She mistimes her jump completely and they're both down. Could that be their last chance? Sunbed Johnny, he's on. Come on, Johnny, you've got to get up. Come on, Johnny. Oh, no, he's down as well. CSI Marion has another go. Come on, go. Oh, no, that was so close. CSI Marion literally a fingertip away from a place in Dizzy Dummies. Catherine now on for another attempt. Oh, she slipped off. That could be it for her. Who is going to make it?
Go!
Geraldine spots an opening, and she's done it!
Geraldine!
After her disappointment last time, she will be thrilled with that. And you can really see what it means to G-Force Geraldine. Total Wipeout, making dreams come true.
Oh, I tell you, the hairs are standing up on my arms. Actually, I think it's a draft from there. So, Geraldine, Eloise, Joe, Dean and Perrin stay in the competition. Sadly for the others, their dream of reaching the Wipeout Zone is no more. Even more sadly, I can't remember their names because I left my notes in the dressing room. Was there a Welding Wendy? Little tiny Carrie? If only there was a way of remembering who they were.
Just can't believe it. I've disappointed myself so much, I needed to get into that final. All my dreams, down the pan.
Oh, it's impossible. It's just really, really slippy and it's moving and you just get flung everywhere. Such is life.
That was a complete disaster for me. I didn't know when to jump, and the times that I did jump, it smacked straight into me and I fell.
I was there with my hand in Joe's hand, hoping that he'd pull me up, and I got knocked off. Really disappointed.
I'd like to see Perrin throw up his lunch on Dizzy Dummies. It'd be nice to see something coming out his mouth anyway.
Dean the Builder, I think he's got a pretty good chance. He really, really wants it. Go Dean!
That's jiggity biggity diggity splash again. That is... normally, it shouldn't be like that.
And just like that, they're out of the game. But there's no time to mope around on Total Wipeout. Let's get on with more of the fun stuff. It's time for Dizzy Dummies.
This is really simple. The contestants are spun in the spinning thing. That's then followed by a leap through the goalie thing. And then there's the huge blobby thing there, that. Yeah, last one across that thing is eliminated for something. And then it kind of happens all over again, but this time one of the contestants will be squashed out of contention with that wall squeeze thing there, leaving the first three across to make it into the Wipeout Zone thing. Easy.
They've crossed a watery ravine, they've climbed the highest mountain, and now for their next adventure, our five heroes are going to get spun around really fast on a really spinny thing. Truly the stuff of legend. It's Dizzy Dummies. Are you all ready? Oh well, we're going anyway. Three, two, one!
In case you haven't been paying attention or just have an appalling memory, here's a reminder of who's still in the game. That's today's fastest qualifier, Dr. Monkey.
Dr. Monkey's back and I'm going to swing through this course!
Cuddling up to her is the Cornish gas bag, Chatty Perrin. Next is the very bouncy and very nervous Dynamo Joe.
The course on the north, I'm going to show you best!
Northern Ireland's finest, G-Force Geraldine. And finally, the part-time Lothario, Dean the Builder.
My name is Dean, and I can't sing!
They've stopped. And it's G-Force Geraldine out first. She will be determined to make the most of this second chance, having been so unlucky in her last show. Ooh, a bit of a roadblock there as the other four queue up to get through the goal. What's Dean up to? Geraldine's raced ahead, but there are no points for being first in the water. Dr. Monkey, son. Closely followed by Nervous Joe. Oh!
Joe took Eloise down. Down to Legend Town.
Pulling another contestant down might be against the rules, but luckily for Joe, Eduardo has misplaced the rule book, so we'll never know. Perrin's all on his own at the front. Oh, yes! Yes! Traditional Cornish celebration there. This is close, get up! Yes, he's done it! He's a man that lets his actions do the talking. Not a word, nothing. Dean the Builder is trying to cross in the sexiest way possible. I'm sure Amanda will be taking note. He really has been the surprise package today. Come on now, Dean, he is so close. Come on, she's watching, this is looking good. We can almost touch the finish line. There you go.
Oh no!
Yeah, I think Dean did touch the finish line, but forgot to hold on to it. Dr. Monkey seems to have successfully made her way to the end of the blob. Is she in, though? Oh, she's still there.
No.
Heloise was knocked out on Dizzy Dummies last time. She won't want to suffer the same fate, so she needs to get a move on. This is excruciating. It's not dignified, but it is excruciating. Watch out for Joe. Oh, it matters not. Dr. Monkey has made it all thanks to her incredible monkey grip. Dean the Builder goes again. He must be replaying that fall over and over in his head, but he needs to put that to one side now and just get on with it.
Joe, you might as well throw Dean off. You've done it to everyone else.
Oh, he's nearly there. He's nearly there. Come on, Dean.
No.
Oh, no, he's off again. You can see his frustration. Joe just has to make this jump. Not as easy as it looks. Getting set up and ready. Can he make it this time? Yes! Yes, Dynamo Joe is safe. Well done, Joe. Just Dean and Geraldine are left to battle it out. Dean's on first.
Geraldine and Dean. There's only a Gerald between them.
G-Force Geraldine slips in again. This is Dean's big chance now. Ooh, I believe it. Dean the Builder is down. Could that mean he's going home? Geraldine has seen that fall, and there is a spring in her step again. And a spring in a sort of crawly, slithery thing as well. Yes. Oh, Dean's down.
Use those driver's legs to get up there.
G-Force Geraldine is through. She will be relieved.
Absolutely gutted.
I know that you wanted more than anyone to get through that.
I did. I wanted to be in the final, and I'm absolutely devastated.
What happened? Because there was a moment when you were actually on the final podium.
I know. Just slipped. I just could not get the grip.
Dean, all right. Well, unfortunately, Dean the Builder could not fix it. Go and let those tears out. We'll see you later.
Thank you.
He's not really going to cry, is he? Sure. As they head into a spin for one last time, this lot will have their sights very much set on a place in the Wipeout Zone. Not one of these four remaining legends has made it to the Wipeout Zone before, but now they've each been given a second opportunity to have their names etched into Total Wipeout folklore. For Geraldine, Joe, Perrin and Heloise, this is their last chance. Like four small children chasing an ice cream van, sort of, they make their way to the goal. And it's Dynamo Joe first, closely followed by G-Force Geraldine. Joe now is miles ahead, and this bodes well for the nervous chap from Yorkshire. Perrin needs to hurry, the others are getting away. But they're not having much joy with that wall squeeze.
Two legends pop through a letterbox.
Well, Joe's made it through, but this is going to end in tears for someone. Ah, Perrin. They're going to be Perrin's tears. He landed on Joe, but ended up pushing him onto the pontoon. Joe just needs to get through the wall squeeze. Only a mistake can stop him from taking his place in the Wipeout Zone for the very first time. Dr. Monkey's just behind, closely followed by Geraldine. Perrin's in real danger of being eliminated now. And Joe is the first through to the Wipeout Zone. That must be quite some feeling. Any of these three could be joining Joe. They've all been so strong today. Geraldine's fallen. G-Force Geraldine in big trouble. Heloise makes her jump. And she's through to the Wipeout Zone. Fantastic. Now Perrin can afford to take his time. He focuses, he jumps, and he's made it. Perrin, Heloise and Joe all take their place in the Wipeout Zone for the very first time. Geraldine is eliminated.
You were very, very close. In fact, you were almost on the final podium. What exactly happened there?
My head was too big.
Listen, Geraldine, hard luck. Go join the others.
Thank you.
Oh, well done. Hard luck. Bye.
Geraldine, what a legend. She's playing up to the crowd there. Oh, that's not supposed to be an obstacle. That's not even on the course.
Finally, Joe, Perrin and Eloise get to fulfil their greatest dream. That is assuming their greatest dream consists of being pummeled with gallons of water and bashed by a knobbly mechanical arm. My binders. Let's find out what all this means to the three lucky legends. I'm sure Perrin will have a lot to say about his experience.
Being back in Argentina is absolutely fantastic. I never thought I'd get to see those big red balls again.
To make it to the Legends final of all the finals, it's going to be the closest final ever. I think no chance that I'm going to get beaten.
To be taking part in Total Wipeout all over again, no words to describe it.
I think I'm going to be the one to beat. I'm fit and strong, but I'm wise.
I think I do deserve to be here. I've worked very hard. I can't wait. I'm going to love it. I'm definitely doing it for the girls.
Three words to describe my Total Wipeout experience would be...
Perrin, the man of few words.
His actions speak louder than words, though.
Extraordinary.
I'm a little guy with a massive heart and a zest for life. That's why I'm called Dynamo Joe.
I don't think there'll ever be an end to the monkey business. Somewhere deep within me knows that I'm a champion.
Let the best man win, woman.
I am going to be a dynamo tonight, certainly. I'm going to sparkle like the biggest diamond in the world.
Everyone loves me, everyone cheers for me. I'm the best. Legend.
The Total Wipeout Legends champion will look very nice on my CV. Thank you very much.
So, Perrin, Heloise and Joe find themselves face to face with the legendary Wipeout Zone. Killer Surf. Don't get killed and try and surf. The Rapid Climb. Climb rapidly or get rapidly wet. The Balance Beam. It's all about one thing. Balancing. And beams. The Crazy Sweeper. No sweeping, but plenty of crazy running. The Tarzan Swing. Swing. Well, I like Tarzan, obviously. And finally, it's the Buzzer, which is all about buzzing.
Second Chance Saloon for three of our legends. None of them have ever got this far before. It's the legendary Wipeout Zone, and the first legend to go is Perrin.
Here he goes, today's second fastest qualifier.
You gotta try this.
Feel the passion, the white hot hunger for victory. And he's away. Managed to stop talking long enough to hit the water. Ooh, that is a bumpy landing for Perrin, even in killer surf terms. He's in the water, and that's a strong swim over to the rapid climb. Battling against that torrent of water is tough. And there's now a 10-second countdown before it's about to get even tougher. That is a fast ascent, though. Perrin reaches the top before the tidal wave is released. And now he's onto the balance beam. Remember, this is Perrin's first time in the Wipeout Zone. He's never tried this before. Missed his chance last time. Desperate to succeed now. He's looking a little wobbly. He's the right way, though. At least he can use the wall to help him along. He's got to post as quick a time as he can. He's past the beam. This is looking like a super fast time on the Wipeout Zone. The Crazy Sweeper now. Off he goes. He's got to move fast. Oh, he's just staying ahead of the sweeper arm, and I mean just. Come on. Oh, oh no. One jump away from a clean sweeper sweep. That means Perrin's had to swim over to the Tarzan swing, which has cost him time. To be honest, he's still got there pretty quickly. Here he goes. This is still a good time, and it looks good. This is superb. What a finish! Barely touched the turntable and completes the course in a staggering 1 minute 33. That will take some beating. Perrin just goes to show that even with a tumble on the Crazy Sweeper, still possible to set an amazing time. The next two legends will have to work very hard to top that.
Listen, you're a man of very few words. How did it feel for you?
Fantastic. Do it again.
That was a very speedy 1 minute and 33 seconds.
Hey, brilliant.
Yeah, Amanda, barely getting a word in edgeways there. Dr. Monkey's next, today's fastest qualifier.
Here goes nothing, Dr. Monkey!
She's off. Heloise starts the Wipeout Zone with a smile on her face. Or it may have been a grimace. She's got no idea that Perrin's 1 minute 33 is the time to beat, and that is going to be tough. All she knows is, as fast as possible. That's a strong pull up onto the rapid climb, and the countdown begins 10 seconds to tidal torrent. Ooh, look at her go. Dr. Monkey is pretty much at the top already. That is incredible. Onto the balance beam now, and Heloise is neck and neck with Perrin at this point. Is she tall enough to reach the wall for balance if she needs it? Just about. Well, it's an unorthodox approach using her monkey skills. And it seems to have worked. Yes, well done. On to the Crazy Sweeper now. Perrin took a dive here, so Heloise can still afford one mistake. Although no mistakes would be better. She goes for it. She goes. Yes, come on, Heloise. What a jump. Fantastic. Now, if there's one thing a monkey should be good at, it's this. Heloise might still beat Perrin's time. I've never seen it this close. She swings. Yes, good landing. One final jump. This is going to be very, very close. I don't believe it. The clock stops on 1:34. 1 second out. That is so close to Perrin's time. And worst of all, she doesn't know it yet. Another amazing Wipeout Zone run from another amazing competitor. Heloise kept up the pace, pausing only briefly on the crazy sweeper, but she's lost out by the slenderest of margins. Amanda, it's over to you to tell her.
Oh my God, my heart is in my mouth. How are you feeling?
Fantastic, that was so much fun.
There was 1 second between you two. Perrin, you were faster. Eloise, I'm sorry, you're out.
All that stands between Perrin and Total Wipeout glory now is 45-year-old Dynamo Joe.
Oh, mother, I think I'm going to pat my pants.
There's water at the bottom. And he's off. Joe crash lands, and his attempt to beat Perrin's incredible time of 1 minute 33 begins. It's the rapid climb first. Both Perrin and Heloise outran the tidal wave. Can Joe do the same? He's up. The 10-second countdown has begun. But Joe looks unconcerned. True to his name, he's flying up the slope. That tidal wave won't be making an appearance today. These legends are just too good. Onto the balance beam now. Joe opting not to lean on the wall. Ooh, and that decision has cost him. That's his first big mistake. There is no room for error now. The bad news for Joe is that he now faces the crazy sweeper. He's dithering. Come on, Joe, you've got to get a move on. Now, this sprint is crucial. He needs to stay ahead of that sweeper. Joe skips across the podiums. Go on, stay ahead. Ooh! Yes, he's made it. He just clears the sweeper arm. And at such speed, it's so close, Joe can still win. He could still do it from here. The Tarzan swing now. Come on, Joe. This is the closest thing I've ever seen. He's across. If he makes this, he will have pulled off the impossible. And no! I can't believe that. No one ever falls off there, but Joe just did. And by doing so, he has let the trophy slip through his fingers. Joe finishes in what is still a very good time. He doesn't know he's lost yet, as you can probably tell from that reaction. After an early mistake on the balance beam, Joe put himself right back in contention, only to make that schoolboy error at the last possible moment. This has been the closest Wipeout Zone ever, and it's time for Amanda to reveal the result.
Joe, how you doing?
I was a little knackered, but didn't quite go to plan, but we still worked hard.
Dynamo Joe and Perrin, I'm going to put you out of your misery. Perrin, you are the Legends champion. Well done! Joe, I'm so sorry.
So, an effusive Perrin Pryor from Cornwall is crowned the Total Wipeout Legends champion. In so doing, the Cornish motormouth has written a whole new chapter of his life story. Honestly, look, I'll read it to you now. Chapter 17. I won the Total Wipeout Legends special. It was nice. The end. It's an incredible feat. So that's it for the first ever Total Wipeout Legends special. Are you thinking what I'm thinking? If you're thinking, where's my cab home? Then you are thinking what I'm thinking. Yeah, it's here. Okay, from Amanda and me, it's good night. Well, she's made it to the balls in super quick time. This woman only knows one way. Oh, now she knows two ways. Yeah, and that one's the wrong way. Geraldine bringing a bit of Irish tradition to the Total Wipeout qualifier. Someone really must have a word with the wardrobe department. We're all sorts of trouble this week. This is looking like a very good time. And she's on to the second cradle. No, she's overbalanced. Or is it underbalanced? She's fallen off is what she's done.
And either way, that is the most surprising fall of the day. She may be strong, but those shorts are very small. She must feel the breeze. That is a quick time of 2 minutes 23, which puts her in second place for now. From one explosive competitor to another, it's the quite fantastic Exploding Kenny. He was the guy who... exploded. That's what he does all day as a science communicator at the Glasgow Science Centre. Apparently.
These legends don't frighten me! I'm gonna be the most legendary legend!
Yeah, Kenny, you're supposed to go out with a bang, not kind of start with one, because we'll come back. Moving on, these next two competitors have one thing in common. Besides them both being men and both being called Ali, it's that they both left Total Wipeout cursing their size and weight. 39-year-old Ali had a unique approach to the big balls.
I tried to do like jiggity-biggity, diggity-bop. But I done like jiggity-biggity-splash. That is fun, isn't it?
Ali, how you doing?
Hello, honey. Nice to see you back. Yes, I am here again.
And have you been down the gym pumping extra iron so that you can ensure first place this time?
No. The first time I was a little bit chunky and heavy. This time is I cut the protein.
So Ali reckons he's lost weight. Okay, let's have a look. It's like a very difficult game to spot the difference. Even the vest is the same. I hope he's washed it, that's all. 26-year-old Disco Al showed off his dancing skills way back in Series 2. Back then, he claimed he was going to eat the course. No, really, he did.
Since you've been here last, what kind of stuff have you been up to?
Well, I've been away and I've got back from this, realised I am grossly overweight and very unfit, so I've went to the gym and I've lost 3.5 stone since then, so...
Good for you, so you're extra fit this time.
Yeah, it may not be, like, super fit, but, you know, it's better than I was, so fingers crossed I'm here to smash my qualifying time from last time.
Just lay off the dancing, Al, and you'll be, fine. Might have lost the weight, but he hasn't lost that dancing talent. You can't lose what you don't have. That's a new move there. Yeah. Paul the Lawnmower, a perennial favourite. Always a good
one. You, and you, bring it on!
Yeah, the only language they understand, Alistair, is pain. Yours. Dodgeball is first for Disco Al. Yeah, successfully batting them away so far. Nice, neat.
Oh!
Cornish Gasbag, Chatty Perrin. Next is the very bouncy and very nervous Dynamo Joe.
The
claw
from the north, gonna show you him best!
Northern Ireland's finest, G-Force Geraldine.
I'm a living legend!
And finally, the part-time Lothario, Dean the Builder.
My name is Dean, and I can't sing!
They've stopped. And it's G-Force Geraldine out first. She will be determined to make the most of this second chance, having been so unlucky in her last show. Ooh, a bit of a roadblock there as the other four queue up to get through the goal. What's Dean up to? Geraldine's raced ahead, but there are no points for being first in the water. Dr. Monkey, son. Closely followed by Nervous Joe. Oh!
Joe took Eloise down. Down to Legend Town.
Pulling another contestant down might be against the rules, but luckily for Joe, Eduardo has misplaced the rule book, so we'll never know. Perrin's all on his own at the front. Oh, yes! Yes! Traditional Cornish celebration there. This is close. Get up! Yes, he's done it! He's a man that lets his actions do the talking. Not a word. Nothing. Dean the Builder is trying to cross in the sexiest way possible. I'm sure Amanda will be taking note. He really has been the surprise package today. Come on now, Dean. He is so close. Come on, she's watching. This is looking good. You can almost touch the finish line. There you go.
Oh, no!
Yeah, I think Dean did touch the finish line, but forgot to hold on to it. Dr. Monkey seems to have successfully made her way to the end of the blob. Is she in, though?
Yeah.
Oh, she's still there.
I don't know.
Heloise was knocked out on Dizzy Dummies last time. She won't want to suffer the same fate, so she needs to get a move on. This is excruciating. It's not dignified, but it is excruciating. Watch out for Joe. Oh, it matters not. Dr. Monkey has made it all thanks to her incredible monkey grip. Dean the Builder goes again. He must be replaying that fall over and over in his head, but he needs to put that to one side now and just get on with it.
Joe, you might as well throw Dean off. You've done it to everyone else.
Oh. He's nearly there. He's nearly there. Come on, Dean. No! Oh, no, he's off again! You can see his frustration. Joe just has to make this jump. Not as easy as it looks. Getting set up and ready. Can he make it this time? Yes! Yes, Dynamo Joe is safe. Well done, Joe.
What are you here to prove today, Phil?
I'm here to prove that anybody off the street can just become a rapper, become a dancer, become a Wipeout celebrity.
Yeah, well, one out of three ain't bad, Phil. Yeah. Time for MC Philly Phil to freestyle with the Sucker Punch. Here we go. Oh, ah! Yeah, Phil proves he knows how to get down and dirty. Very dirty. That's a time of 3 minutes 26 in the end, quicker than Maria, slower than everyone else.
And that, my friends, is a wrap.
That's 4 legendurous performances down. And while I'm making up words, next to run are a pair of competitor ets from the sunny south coast. Who will be crowned betterest? Will I start speaking normally again? I really hope so. I'm annoying myself.
Ah, remember Charlene, 21-year-old makeup artist and former Miss Bournemouth. She was a real girly girl. Yeah, she looked so pretty in pink. Less pretty after a visit to the qualifier. Well, she's back now to prove she's the queen of the English Riviera. While Bournemouth has Charlene, Portsmouth has Amy, the 19-year-old model immortalised by a pair of magic shorts. She's back to prove she's the South Coast finest.
Amy, the last time you were here, you had what we tend to call in the business quite a few of those wedgie things, didn't you?
Yeah, yeah.
I don't care if I get a wedgie. I'm not pulling that out. I'm going.
So Amy is up and away. Oh dear, did she just already? Yep, the magic's returned. Hard to believe they are different shorts. I'm hopeful Amy will have a strong start because she is desperate to make it. Oh! Oh no, I'm way too hopeful. The dodgeball boys, of course, are suckers for a pretty face, so I expect them to go easy on Charlene. Yep, they're definitely going easy on her. Oh! I really must stop saying things like that. Yeah, this is a disaster waiting to happen. I'm not talking about that hit on the bombs. Those red balls, like, totally clash with that pink leotard thing. It's terrible. Back to Amy and her new magic shorts.
She promised she wouldn't pull them out of her bottom.
Yeah, well, we can all make promises like that, but come on, needs must. Right, the sucker punch. And, oh, Amy's already in. That mud is almost 30% motor oil, so it should help those squeaky shorts at least. No. Can Charlene do any better?
She's so pretty in pink.
No. Charlene got all the way to Dizzy Dummies last time. She'll want to make the most of this second chance and go one better today. The big balls now. Oh. Oh. Oh yeah. Sheer delight.
Perrin! You were faster! Eloise, I'm sorry, you're out!
All that stands between Perrin and Total Wipeout glory now is 45-year-old Dynamo Joe.
Oh, mother, I think I'm gonna bat my pants!
Ugh, that's... well, there's water at the bottom. And he's off! Joe crash lands, and his attempt to beat Perrin's incredible time of 1 minute 33 begins. It's the rapid climb first. Both Perrin and Heloise outran the tidal wave. Can Joe do the same? He's up. The 10-second countdown has begun. But Joe looks unconcerned. True to his name, he's flying up the slope. That tidal wave won't be making an appearance today. These legends are just too good. Onto the balance beam now. Joe opting not to lean on the wall. Ooh, and that decision has cost him. That's his first big mistake. There is no room for error now. Bad news for Joe is that he now faces the crazy sweeper. He's dithering. Come on, Joe, you've got to get a move on. Now, this sprint is crucial. He needs to stay ahead of that sweeper. Joe skips across the podiums. Go on, stay ahead. Ooh! Yes, he's made it. He just clears the sweeper arm. And at such speed, it's so close, Joe can still win. He could still do it from here. The Tarzan swing now. Come on, Joe. This is the closest thing I've ever seen. He's across. If he makes this, he will have pulled off the impossible. And... no! Oh, I can't believe that. No one ever falls off there, but Joe just did. And by doing so, he's let the trophy slip through his fingers. Joe finishes in what is still a very good time. He doesn't know he's lost yet, as you can probably tell from that reaction. After an early mistake on the balance beam, Joe put himself right back in contention, only to make that schoolboy error at the last possible moment. This has been the closest Wipeout Zone ever, and it's time for Amanda to reveal the result.
Joe, how you doing?
Oh, I was at the knackered, but didn't quite go to plan, but we still worked hard.
Dynamo Joe and Perrin, I'm going to put you out of your misery. Perrin, you are the Legends champion. Well done! Joe, I'm so sorry.
So, an effusive Perrin Pryor from Cornwall is crowned the Total Wipeout Legends champion. In so doing, the Cornish motormouth has written a whole new chapter of his life story. Honestly, look, I'll read it to you now. Chapter 17. I won the Total Wipeout, or just have an appalling memory. Here's a reminder of who's still in the game. That's today's fastest qualifier, Dr. Monkey.
Dr. Monkey's back, and I'm going to swing through this course.
Cuddling up to her is the Cornish gas bag, Chatty Perrin. Next is the very bouncy and very nervous Dynamo Joe.
The course
for
the north, I'm going to show you the best.
Northern Ireland's finest, G-Force Geraldine.
I'm a living legend!
And finally, the part-time Lothario, Dean the Builder.
My name is Dean, and I can't sing!
They've stopped. And it's G-Force Geraldine out first. She will be determined to make the most of this second chance, having been so unlucky in her last show. Ooh, a bit of a roadblock there as the other four queue up to get through the goal. What's Dean up to? Geraldine's raced ahead, but there are no points for being first in the water. Dr. Monkey hops on. Closely followed by Nervous Joe. Oh.
Joe took Eloise down. Down to Legend Town.
Pulling another contestant down might be against the rules, but luckily for Joe, Eduardo has misplaced the rule book, so we'll never know. Perrin's all on his own at the front. Oh, yes! Yes! Traditional Cornish celebration there. This is close. Get up! Yes, he's done it! He's a man that lets his actions do the talking. Not a word. Nothing. Dean the Builder is trying to cross in the sexiest way possible. I'm sure Amanda will be taking note. He really has been the surprise package today. Come on now, Dean. He is so close. Come on, she's watching. This is looking good. You can almost touch the finish line. There you go.
Oh, no!
Yeah, I think Dean did touch the finish line, but forgot to hold on to it. Dr. Monkey seems to have successfully made her way to the end of the blob. Is she in, though? Oh, she's still there.
No, no, no.
Heloise was knocked out on Dizzy Dummies last time. She won't want to suffer the same fate, so she needs to get a move on. This is excruciating. It's not dignified, but it is excruciating. Watch out for Joe. Oh, it matters not. Dr. Monkey has made it all thanks to her incredible monkey grip. Dean the Builder goes again. He must be replaying that fall over and over in his head, but he needs to put that to one side now and just get on with
Joe,
it.
Joe, you might as well throw Dean off. You've done it to everyone else.
Oh. He's nearly there. He's nearly there. Come on, Dean.
No.
Oh, no, he's off again. You can see his frustration. Joe just has to make this jump. Not as easy as it looks. They had that practice. This is looking good. Oh, yes, clear. Yeah, the big balls now. Okay, Dynamo Joe, here he goes. Yes, yes. Oh!
All that practicing, that jumping.
Joe, don't interrupt her. Don't ever interrupt Amanda. See, it was good bounce, and then another good bounce, and then, no, it all went wrong.
Now, the only thing between Joe and the finish line are the cradles of doom now. Let me just explain how these work using a detailed description and some state-of-the-art computer graphics. You jump across them like that. There. Right, Joe's put his early nerves behind him. Can he finish in style? Yes, he can, in a time of 1 minute 44.
Who's the daddy? Who's the daddy?
Clearly, Joe's the daddy.
Yeah, Dynamo Hannah's daddy. We all know that.
I was listening to you saying something about not Dynamo Joe Muhammad Ali. What was that?
Oh, it's my little rhyme. I was saying to this little bunch, float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. I'm Dynamo Joe, not Muhammad Ali.
Oh, yeah, wordsmith as well.
What a great way to start the Legends special. But now we need someone who can really light up this course. Not literally, though. Obviously, there's a lot of foam out there. I mean, it's all undergone extensive fire safety testing and everything. It failed. They can catch fire really easily. I mean, even friction can do it. But I'm sure it'll be fine.
Now, who's this? I can't quite tell. I don't believe it. It's the one and only Maria, a true legend of legends. She wowed the nation with her dancing and with her uncrushable spirit last time out. She epitomised what Total Wipeout is all about, getting coated in mud and falling over a lot.
Amazing.
So, Maria, have you been doing much of the physical stuff in order to prepare you for this today?
Well, it's funny you say that. I've been for one run. I've done a few sit-ups. And a moonwalk, I've got that down to a T, so that'll help me get through.
Oh yes, I can't wait to see this moonwalk. Any minute now, she'll do the moonwalk. Seriously, any minute, she's gonna moonwalk for us. It's gonna happen.
Oh, I nearly fell over there.
Oh dear.
Last time I was the one and only, but this time I'm back for the final countdown, doo-doo-doo, cause I'm simply the best.
As a medley! Beautiful! I've missed you, Maria! A new challenge awaits, of course.
Oh, no.
Yeah, dodgeball. Good dodging. Oh! Right on the noggin! Ow! That's some pretty accurate ball throwing. But Maria doesn't move an inch. She's a professional. Yeah, oh! Yeah, that's to be expected.
Oh, yeah, she certainly is the one and the only.
Now Maria will be hell-bent on making it through the qualifier after finishing one place from the bottom last time.
Over a year since I've seen you last, what did your family think of your performance?
Oh, they loved it. Even my daughter's school friends call her Dynamo Hannah now, so it's, you know, it's dropping down from family to... stay at that again.
Take your time, Joe. Take your time.
What are you here to prove today?
I'm here doing it for all the little, short, ugly blokes that are balding, getting 47-year-old. Oh no, I've done it again wrong again.
Just breathe, Joe. Breathe.
Job. Thank you very much. High five.
I hope he pulls himself together before he starts.
You've seen the least from the east, and you've seen the rest from the west. Now the dwarf from the north is going to show you him best.
What?
Yeah. I think Joe is officially nervous, but that's okay. We'll excuse him that. And he's on. Sorry, let me do that again. He's off. Yes. Right, the first obstacle for Dynamo Joe is the dodgeball. Oh yeah, four legends in their own right, and back again to welcome the competitors to the qualifier by pelting them with small red balls. Apparently they can only speak four words. Duck, dive, dodge, and destroy. Yeah, so after those early nerves, this looks like a decent start for Joe. He's doing well, he's not doing so well. Yeah, takes his first hit but tries to lie down when he probably should have run for it or something. The sucker punch! Joe failed to cross the sucker punch last time. How will he do now, having had that practice? This is looking good. Oh, yes, clear! Yeah, the big balls now. Okay, Dynamo Joe, here he goes. Yes, yes! Oh!
All that practicing, that jumping.
Joe, don't interrupt her. Don't ever interrupt Amanda. See, it was good bounce, and then another good bounce, and then, no, it all went wrong. God, went. Now, the only thing between Joe and the finish line are the cradles of doom now. Let me just explain how these work, using a detailed description and some state-of-the-art computer graphics. You jump across them like that. There. Right, Joe's put his early nerves behind him. Can he finish in style? Yes, he can, in a time of 1 minute 44.
Who's the daddy? Who's the daddy?
Clearly, Joe's the daddy.
Yeah, Dynamo Hannah's daddy. We all know that.
I was listening to you saying something about not Dynamo Joe Muhammad Ali. What was that?
Oh, it's my little rhyme. I was saying to this little bunch, float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. I'm Dynamo Joe, not Muhammad Ali.
Oh, yeah. Wordsmith as well.
What a great way to start the Legends special. But now we need someone who can really light up this course. Not literally, though. Obviously, there's a lot of foam out there. I mean, it's all undergone extensive fire safety testing and everything. It failed. They can catch fire really easily. I mean, even friction can do it. But I'm sure it'll be fine.
Now, who's this?
I can't quite tell.
I dub an orthodox approach using her monkey skills. And it seems to have worked. Yes, well done. On to the crazy sweeper now. Heron took a dive here, so Heloise can still afford one mistake, although no mistakes would be better. She goes for it. She goes. Yes, come on, Heloise. What a jump. Fantastic. Now, if there's one thing a monkey should be good at, it's this. Heloise might still beat Perrin's time. I've never seen it this close. She swings. Yes, good landing. One final jump. This is going to be very, very close. I don't believe it. The clock stops on 1:34. 1 second out. That is so close to Perrin's time. And worst of all, she doesn't know it yet. Another amazing Wipeout Zone run from another amazing competitor. Heloise kept up the pace, pausing only briefly on the crazy sweeper, but she's lost out by the slenderest of margins. Amanda, it's over to you to tell her.
Oh my God, my heart is in my mouth. How are you feeling?
Fantastic, that was so much fun.
There was 1 second between you two. Perrin, you were faster. Eloise, I'm sorry, you're out.
All that stands between Perrin and Total Wipeout glory now is 45-year-old Dynamo Joe.
Oh, mother, I think I'm going to pat my pants.
There's water at the bottom.
And he's off. Joe crash lands, and his attempt to beat Perrin's incredible time of 1 minute 33 begins. It's the rapid climb first. Both Perrin and Heloise outran the tidal wave. Can Joe do the same? He's up. The 10-second countdown has begun. But Joe looks unconcerned. True to his name, he's flying up the slope. That tidal wave won't be making an appearance today. These legends are just too good. Onto the balance beam now. Joe opting not to lean on the wall. Ooh, and that decision has cost him. That's his first big mistake. There is no room for error now. The bad news for Joe is that he now faces the crazy sweeper. He's dithering. Come on, Joe, you've got to get a move on. Now, this sprint is crucial. He needs to stay ahead of that sweeper. Joe skips across the podiums. Go on, stay ahead. Ooh! Yes, he's made it. He just clears the sweeper arm. And at such speed, it's so close, Joe can still win. He could still do it from here. The Tarzan swing now. Come on, Joe. This is the closest thing I've ever seen. He's across it because this one's got a ledge and an end.
Now, I'd like to hand over to someone who's always there to encourage the competitors. Someone who brightens up the show. Someone who's got a big, caring heart and a gorgeous smile. Unfortunately, though, Eduardo's camera shy. So instead, let's go over to Amanda Byram, who's with today's first competitor.
Ah, yes, it's 45-year-old Dynamo Joe from Yorkshire. Just what's needed, a really strong, confident competitor up first.
Who's the daddy? Who's the daddy?
This guy was one of the bounciest competitors ever seen on Total Wipeout, but was surprisingly knocked out by the sweeper last time around.
It's been over a year since I've seen you last. What did your family think of your performance?
Oh, they loved it. Even my daughter's school friends call her Dynamo Hannah now, so... It's dropping down from family to... stay at that again.
Take your time, Joe. Take your time.
What are you here to prove today?
I'm here doing it for all the little, short, ugly blokes that are balding, getting 47-year-old. Oh, no, I've done it again wrong again.
Just breathe, Joe. Breathe.
Joe. Thank you very much. High five.
I hope he pulls himself together before he starts.
You've seen the least from the east, and you've seen the rest from the west. Now the dwarf from the north is going to show you him best.
What?
Yeah. I think Joe is officially nervous. But that's okay. We'll excuse him that. And he's on. Sorry, let me do that again. He's off. Yes. Right, the first obstacle for Dynamo Joe is the dodgeball. Oh, yeah. Four legends in their own right, and back again to welcome the competitors to the qualifier by pelting them with small red balls. Apparently, they can only speak four words. Duck, dive, dodge, and destroy. Yeah, so after those early nerves, this looks like a decent start for Joe. He's doing well. He's not doing so well. Yeah, takes his first hit, but tries to lie down when he probably should have run for it or something. The sucker punch. Joe failed to cross the sucker punch last time. How will he do now, having had that practice? This is looking good. Oh, yes, clear. Yeah, the big balls now. Okay, Dynamo Joe, here he goes. Yes, yes. Oh!
All that practicing, that jumping.
Joe, don't interrupt her. Don't ever interrupt Amanda. See, it was good bounce, and then another good bounce, and then, no, it all went wrong. Got wet. Now, the only thing between Joe and the finish line are the cradles of doom now. Let me just explain how these work, using a detailed description and some state-of-the-art computer graphics. You jump across them like that. There. Right, Joe's put his early nerves behind him. Can he finish in style? Yes, he can, in a time of 1 minute 44.
Who's the daddy? Who's the daddy?
I love these guys. Anyway, it's time for another legendary legend. I can hardly contain myself. Don't worry, I have. It's just this belt's a bit broken, isn't it? But I am contained. Who's next?
Oh, yes, it's 19-year-old former pastry roller from Cornwall, Perrin. He's got the most spectacular sweeper wipeout to his name, along with the least spectacular interview technique.
Perrin, you are just oozing cool. Are you excited about the course today?
Yeah.
Really looking forward to it then, are we?
Yeah, man.
Can he contain his excitement, having been asked back for another bite of the Total Wipeout cherry?
So, is it good to be back on Total Wipeout, Perrin?
Fantastic.
Yeah. Yeah, he can contain his excitement, he can. Right, he's off. And it's dodgeball first, remember. Now, these boys are part human, part robot, whereas Perrin's part Cornishman, part Wookiee. This could be quite a battle. Ooh. Moving when you see it in slow motion in a really odd sort of way. This is a very quick time as Perrin speeds towards the big balls. Whoa! Oh! Oh! That was tremendous! That's gonna be the fall of the day on the big balls. Incredible! Perrin onto the cradles in a flash. Makes his move, second cradle now. Can he finish in style and leapfrog Joe at the top of the leaderboard? Yes, he can, in an electric 1 minute 34. Now, he must have something to say about that. Mm-hmm. Come on, a comment. Yes. Mm-hmm. Give the man a chat show. The Legends leaderboard now looks like this, with Chatty Perrin in top spot, Dynamo Joe in second, and CSI Marion in third. G-Force Geraldine is fourth, and Sunbed Johnny is sixth. Exploding Kenny is seventh, formerly Miss Bournemouth, eighth. Disco Al is down there in 11th with the one and only Maria in 12th.
They might not have realised it yet, but the epithet legend wasn't necessarily bestowed upon this lot because of their brilliance. Although in Perrin's case, he is good, isn't he? Chatty, no. But good, yes.
These next two legendary ladies are a right pair of speed queens. 25-year-old Bouncy Becky was the fastest girl in her show, and 30-year-old Can Can Claire was the quickest in her qualifier. But who can go quickest today? And can either of them outpace Perrin? I bet they can't. I don't know. Now, on Becky's previous outing on the qualifier, she became one of the very few to manage the dodge part of dodgeball. How will she get on today? Dodging. Oh! Right on the noggin. Ow! That's some pretty accurate ball throwing. But Maria doesn't move an inch. She's a professional. Yeah, oh. Yeah, that's to be expected.
Oh, yeah. She certainly is the one and the only.
Now, Maria will be hell-bent on making it through the qualifier after finishing one place from the bottom last time round.
Legend.
Some magic on the ball should go a long way to making that happen. Come on. Oh, Maria, watch out for the motivator. Yeah, that's the motivator.
That was a big boom.
Yeah, it was.
I can still see the imprint of her bum.
Maria, you have been motivated. See? She got a move on, didn't she? It does work. Look, 1 minute not going, next minute going. Really fast with her eyes shut. Fabulous. 75 quid that motivator cost. Money well spent. So it's on to the cradles of doom. Oh, good. Ooh, she's made the first cradle. Come on, Maria. A strong finish here. Come on, the whole nation is behind you. We are. I want you to do well. Come on. Here we go. Here she goes. Oh, no.
Whoops.
The one and only Maria finishes in 5 minutes 24. Just one thing left for her to do. That's my girl.
That was unbelievable. Ooh, I tell you what. Boom. Boom. Literally boom.
Right, who's next? Oh, brilliant. It's 38-year-old Sunbed Johnny.
Welcome back. Orange as ever, I see.
Yeah, still using the sunbed. Hoping to win so I can get another one.
Listen, a lot's happened since the last time I saw you. Tell me what's been going on.
Well, my twin brother came, didn't he? And he won. So, I mean, I can't go back empty-handed this time. There's a lot of rivalry between us. I've just got to beat him. Need to beat him.
Now, Sunbed Johnny's dodgeball experience from his first time on the show should stand him in good stead. If you call getting your head knocked off by a ball experience. So he's doing better than last time, but he's still sort of on his feet. Oh, no, spoke too soon.
Spot the weaker brother.
If he wins, Johnny has said he's going to buy another sunbed. Oh, yep, yeah, that's just what that guy needs, isn't it? Another sunbed. Yep, here we go. Nope! That's not mud splashing out of the water, by the way. That's fake tan. Your brother is going to love that. Which might not be very long, depending upon how the qualifier goes. 42-year-old Geraldine exploded through the qualifier, but surprisingly crashed out on Crash Mountain back in the hazy mists of time. Though she's made it to the balls in super quick time, this woman only knows one way. Oh, now she knows two ways. Yeah, and that one's the wrong way. Geraldine bringing a bit of Irish tradition to the Total Wipeout qualifier. Someone really must have a word with the wardrobe department. We're all sorts of trouble this week. This is looking like a very good time. And she's on to the second cradle. No, she's overbalanced. Or is it underbalanced? She's fallen off is what she's done. And either way, that is the most surprising fall of the day. She may be strong, but those shorts are very small. She must feel the breeze. That is a quick time of 2 minutes 23, which puts her in second place, for now. From one explosive competitor to another, it's the quite fantastic Exploding Kenny. He was the guy who... Well, yeah, exploded. That's what he does all day as a science communicator at the Glasgow Science Centre. Apparently.
These legends don't frighten me! I'm gonna be the most legendary legend!
Yeah, Kenny, you're supposed to go out with a bang, not kind of start with one, because we'll come back. Moving on, these next two competitors have one thing in common. Besides them both being men and both being called Ali, it's that they both left Total Wipeout cursing their size and weight. 39-year-old Ali had a unique approach to the big balls.
I tried to do like jiggity biggity, diggity bop. But I done like jiggity biggity splash. That is fun, isn't it?
Ali, how you doing?
Hello, honey. Nice to see you back. Yes, I am here again.
And have you been down the gym pumping extra iron so that you can ensure first place this time?
No. The first time I was a little bit chunky and heavy. This time is I cut the protein.
So Ali reckons he's lost weight. Okay, let's have a look. It's like a very difficult game to spot the difference. Even the vest is the same. I hope he washed it, that's all. 26-year-old Disco Al showed off his dancing skills way back in Series 2. Back then he claimed he was going to eat the course. No, really, he did.
Since you've been here last,
What kind of stuff have you been up to?
Well, I've been away and I've got back from this, realised I am grossly overweight and very unfit, so I've went to the gym and I've lost 3.5 stone since then. So.
Good for you, so you're extra fit this time.
It may not be like super fit, but you know, it's better than I was, so fingers crossed I'm here to smash my qualifying time from last time.
Just lay off the dancing, Al, and you'll be fine. Might have lost the weight, but he hasn't lost that dancing talent. You can't lose what you don't have. That's a new move there. Yeah. Paul the lawnmower, a perennial favourite. Always a good
You, and you, bring it on. And then...
See, it was good bounce, and then another good bounce, and then, no, it all went wrong. Now, the only thing between Joe and the finish line are the cradles of doom now. Let me just explain how these work using a detailed description and some state-of-the-art computer graphics. You jump across them like that. There. Right, Joe's put his early nerves behind him. Can he finish in style? Yes, he can, in a time of 1 minute 44.
Who's the daddy? Who's the daddy?
Clearly Joe's the daddy.
Yeah, Dynamo Hannah's daddy. We all know that.
I was listening to you saying something about not Dynamo Joe Muhammad Ali. What was that?
Oh, it's my little rhyme. I was saying to this other bunch, float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. I'm Dynamo Joe, not Muhammad Ali.
Oh, yeah. Wordsmith as well.
What a great way to start the Legends special. But now we need someone who can really light up this course. Not literally, though. Obviously, there's a lot of foam out there. I mean, it's all undergone extensive fire safety testing and everything. It failed. They can catch fire really easily. I mean, even friction can do it. But I'm sure it'll be fine.
Now, who's this? I can't quite tell. I don't believe it. It's the one and only Maria, a true legend of legends. She wowed the nation with her dancing and with her uncrushable spirit last time out. She epitomised what Total Wipeout is all about, getting coated in mud and falling over a lot.
Amazing. So, Maria, have you been doing much of the physical stuff in order to prepare you for this today?
Well, it's funny you say that. I've been for one run. I've done a few sit-ups and a moonwalk. I've got that down to a T, so that'll help me get through.
Oh, yes. I can't wait to see this moonwalk. Any minute now, she'll do the moonwalk. Seriously, any minute, she's gonna moonwalk for us. It's going to happen.
Oh, I nearly fell over there.
Oh, dear.
Last time, I was the one and only, but this time I'm back for the final countdown. Because I'm simply the best.
That was a medley! Beautiful! I've missed you, Maria! A new challenge awaits, of course.
Oh, no.
Yeah, dodgeball. Good dodging. Oh! Right on the noggin! Ow! That's some pretty accurate ball throwing. But Maria doesn't move an inch. She's a professional. Yeah, oh! Yeah, that's to be expected.
Oh, yeah, she certainly is the one and the only.
Now Maria will be hell-bent on making it through the qualifier after finishing one place from the bottom last time round.
Legend.
The magic on the ball should go a long way to making that happen. Come on! Oh, Maria, watch out for the motivator! Yeah, that's the motivator.
That was a big boom!
Yeah, it was!
I can still see the imprint of her butt.